Already we have started this chapter radioactivity and we are into part 3. Let's have a glance at what we have done in part 1 and part 2. Part 1 and part 2 we have spoken about the atomic structure. Atom is made up of protons, neutrons and electrons. Protons and neutrons are situated at the center, that is nucleus, and electrons revolve in an orbit around the nucleus. From this table we have to memorize the symbol of protons, electrons and neutrons, their mass in terms of kgs, their charges and their locations. Their masses and charges are more important. And this part, atomic number and atomic mass number. So atomic number is represented by a symbol Z or Z. Now atomic number means number of protons or electrons. So Z is number of protons or number of electrons. Protons which carries positive charge and electrons which carries negative charge. Its number is the atomic number. And what about the mass number? Mass number is number of protons plus number of neutrons. Neutron has a zero charge, right? So mass number formula is this, but symbol for mass number is not M, it is A. A is equal to number of protons plus number of neutrons. So in turns, if you have to find out number of neutrons, so that is A minus number of protons, or we can say A minus number of protons is represented by Z. So this part is very important. I'll take an example and I'll show that this kind of questions was asked in a numericals in a board examination. To continue with, we also have seen what do we mean by isotopes, isobar and isotones. So I urge you all to please watch the other parts of this video also. Don't directly come to part 3 without watching part 1 and part 2. Watch the video in the chronology. Now what is the position of a lead in a periodic table? Now atomic number of lead is 82. So in a periodic table it is 82nd element. This position is very important as far as radioactivity is concerned. Why? As you go higher and higher, number of protons, number of electrons, number of neutrons, that increases. That makes element or atom of the element heavier. So lead is the last element which is a stable heavy element. If you know, I have told you that the entire body of Madame Curie has become radioactivity by continuous exposure to the radioactive radiations. Her body is buried in a coffin and this coffin is covered by 1 inch thick of lead. Why? Because lead is the last heaviest stable element and it does not produce radiation and it has a capability to stop the radiation. Lead is the last element in a periodic table which does not show radioactivity. All the elements after lead, they shows the radiation. They shows the phenomenon of radioactivity. And heavier element keeps on giving out a radiation. And every time they give the radiation, they lose their protons, electrons and neutrons. And they become lighter and lighter. And finally, the radioactive radiation stop when they become lead. Difficult to understand, but don't worry, I will explain you this with an example. Now this 18 question subpart number 2. So this is uranium, atomic number is 92 and mass number is 238. When it emits alpha particle, mass number decreases by 4. So 238 minus 4 is 234. And atomic number decreases by 2. 92 minus 2 is 90. And this is atomic number and mass number of a thorium. So we can clearly say that by emission of alpha particle, heavier element uranium with mass 238 amu is converted into a lighter element thorium with mass 234. 238 is greater than 234, or in other words, 234 is smaller than 238. So because of this radiation, heavier element has become a lighter element. I know you have not understood much about it, but even if you have not understood anything, just focus on this part. That is, whenever there is a radioactive emission, So element loses its protons, neutrons, electrons. So there is a change, and whenever there is certain loss, heavy element will become a lighter element. But as of now, remember that whenever there is a radiation, there is a loss in the mass, and heavier element becomes lighter element, and this process continues till it becomes lead. This process will stop at lead because lead is a stable element. Heating, freezing, change of temperature, change of pressure, formation of cations, formation of anion, chemical activities like oxidation, reduction, etc. takes place in an element lighter than lead. Below lead, chemical changes, and above lead, radioactive reactions. I want to underline this point that radioactivity is possible only when this ratio of number of neutrons and number of protons is greater than 1.5. Let us consider the example of a heavy element, uranium, which is also a radioactive element. Atomic number is 92 and mass number is 238. So what is the number of neutrons? So for number of neutrons, formula is A minus Z, that is mass number 238 minus atomic number, that is 92. So how much is the answer? Is it 146? So 146 is the number of neutrons. So what if we take ratio of number of neutrons and number of protons? So number of neutrons is 146 and number of proton is 92. What is answer for this? On division, we get answer as 1.587 approximately, and this value is definitely greater than 1.5. So radioactivity is possible only when this ratio N by P is greater than 1.5. So this ratio is responsible for the phenomenon of radioactivity. So in examination, what is the main cause of radioactivity? So difference in the number of neutrons and protons. Generally, we have seen that for all the stable elements, number of protons and neutrons are almost same. But here there is a difference. Here this ratio is greater than 1.5. So this ratio of neutron to proton, which is greater than 1.5, is responsible for the radioactivity. So radioactive substances, the substances which disintegrate by spontaneous emission of radiation, are called radioactive substances. Disintegrate means they divide. Elements heavier than lead have unstable nucleus. In nucleus of the radioactive elements, number of neutrons are not only greater, but they are much greater than number of protons, such that the ratio of number of neutrons to number of proton is greater than 1.5. Hence the phenomenon radioactivity. Examples of radioactive elements are uranium, radium, polonium, thorium, actinium, etc. In all the elements, you will see that ratio of number of neutrons to number of proton is greater than 1.5. Here example of uranium is given, it is 1.587. This is true for all the other element also. So we can sum up radioactivity by saying that it is a nuclear phenomenon. It happens from the nucleus of an atom. It is spontaneous. We do not interfere in this reaction. It is spontaneous. It happens on its own. And disintegration of an unstable element. So uranium will disintegrate into two lighter and stable elements. Yes, we will learn this with the help of the chemical reaction also. And radioactive element causes emission of alpha, beta and gamma particle. Now we will concentrate on these particles or these radiations, alpha, beta and gamma. So go through this question: when does nucleus of an atom become radioactive? So it becomes radioactive when the ratio of neutron and proton is greater than 1.5. Very important question. Let us continue. A beautiful diagram in front of you. Either they will ask you to draw this diagram or maybe they will give you a diagram followed by some questions below the diagram, and you will be required to answer a question related to that question. So there will be a definite question related to a diagram of the radioactivity. So here what we see is magnetic field part A, and part B is the electric field. So first we will concentrate on the electric field. If you are asked to draw this diagram in the examination, how are you going to go about it? Okay, that is what I'm going to teach you now. So be ready with your pen, pencil. If you don't have pen and pencil with you, you can pause this video right now. Take your book and pencil and you can start watching this video again. So here I go. First, what are you going to do is you are going to draw a box in which you are going to place a radioactive element. So this box will have a very narrow opening. So my radioactive element will be placed somewhere here. Let us say this is a radioactive element. This is, say, uranium. And what is this box made up of? Yes, lead. This is lead box. Why lead box? Because lead is a stable, heavier element. It does not radiate, and it also have a capability to stop the radiation. There are three kinds of radiation coming out from a radioactive element, and these radiations are called alpha, beta and gamma. So this is a radioactive element which is going to give a radiation. And this lead box, why it has a small opening? Because radiation then will pass along a straight line. We can do our experiment on those radiation. Now you are about to draw a radioactive radiations. So first I will draw is the gamma particle. And what am I going to do is I am going to draw three gamma particles straight going. And this gamma particle does not deviate or change the path. 1, 2 and 3. Right? And this radiation is subjected to an electric field. We place an electric field perpendicular to the path at a 90 degree. If this is a path of a radiation, so field, our electric field is perpendicular to it. So here let me say this is negative terminal and this is positive terminal. Now when you draw this diagram, you have in your hand which terminal should be negative and which terminal should be positive. Now what are alpha particles? You have to remember that alpha particle is made up of two protons and two neutrons. What is an alpha particle? A single alpha particle is composed of two protons and two neutrons. Hang on, you will say, sir, helium, second element of a periodic table, it has two protons and two neutrons. So atomic number is 2, mass number is 4, and it has two electrons also. So yes, from this helium atom, if you remove two electrons, what you get is the alpha particles. So we can say that alpha particle is what? It is a helium nucleus. Very important from your examination point of view. It is helium nucleus. Consider a helium atom. It is made up of two protons, two neutrons and two electrons. If you remove two electrons, what you are left with? Nucleus with two protons and two electrons. This exact helium nucleus is the alpha particles. So charge carried by alpha particle is positive. Very important question in the examination. How do you see alpha particle? What are alpha particle? Alpha particle is helium atom without electrons, or alpha particle is helium nucleus with two protons and two electrons. Since it has two protons, it has two positive charges. So when alpha particle have positive charges, that too two positive charges, so it will be deflected towards the negative terminal. So 1, 2 and 3, and please make sure that when you draw this arrow, it is below the gamma particles. These are gamma particles and this is alpha particle. Alpha particle has two positive charges, so it will bend to the negative side of the electric field. And what about the alpha particles? As I told you, alpha particles are nothing but electrons. In those days, when we got an idea about a beta particles, electrons were not discovered. So we called them a beta radiation. Beta radiation is a stream of electron. What is stream of electrons? So electron one after the another. Okay, this stream in a form of a stream, this is the beta radiation. So beta radiation is negatively charged, only one negative charge. Beta particle has only one negative charge because electron has only one negative charge. Even if you see the mass of the electron and if you compare it with the mass of proton and neutron, it is much lighter than the proton or a neutron. That too, here there are two protons and two neutrons, whereas beta particle is just one electron, so it is much lighter than the alpha particle and charge is negative, so it will bend towards the positive side of the electric field. And the angle of deviation will be more because beta particles are much lighter than the alpha particle. Alpha particles are made of two protons and two neutrons, so its mass can be 4 amu. And if you compare the mass of electron with the mass of one proton or one neutron also, it is almost 2000 times lighter than the single proton or a single neutron. So it has comparatively very less mass as well as a negative charge. Because of less mass, it deviates more. The angle of deviation is more. And it has a negative charge, so it bends towards this positive side of the electric field, and alpha particle towards the negative side. So this is the exact way in which you are going to draw a diagram. Point to be noted is that you are going to draw 3 gamma particles, 3 alpha particles and 3 beta particles. And you will see that gamma particles go straight without any deviation. And alpha particles deviate towards the negative side. Height is more than the beta particle. And whereas angle of beta particle is more, you can even increase this angle to almost 90 degree also. It is much lighter than the alpha particles and bend towards the positive terminal. If you draw a diagram like this with a proper labeling, you will get full marks. I hope now you don't have any doubt with alpha, beta and gamma particle, and this was comparatively easier than the magnetic field. When we talk about a magnetic field, we have to consider two cases. So what I'll do is I'll divide this page into two parts. So here I have a lead box with a narrow opening. And a radioactive element is placed inside it. Again here also I have a lead box with a narrow opening and a radioactive element placed into it. Right? So exam question, why lead? Because it is stable element, it has a capacity to stop alpha, beta and gamma radiation. It is a thick lead box. And this time we have a magnetic field. Magnetic field is a game changer. Most of the students go wrong here. I am sure if you listen to my explanation carefully, you will not go wrong. Now magnetic field is a vector quantity. And what is a vector quantity? Vector quantity has a direction. So you have to now think in terms of 3D geometry. Along with x-axis and y-axis, you have to think about a z-axis also. You have to think about a space. When you go to watch a 3D movie, what is the speciality of a 3D movie? In 3D movie, things are thrown at you. A normal 2D movie has only two dimensions, that is x-axis and y-axis. In a 3D movie, there is third dimension also, that is z-axis, so which is coming outside. So this z-axis can be coming outside towards you or going inside the plane away from you. So you can consider now this screen as two dimension where I have x-axis and y-axis. Magnetic field I can show with the help of cross also. This cross has a different meaning. Now, what is meaning of this cross? Here I am going to show this with the help of dots. Cross has a different meaning and dots have a different meaning. Remember, magnetic field is a vector quantity. It has a direction. Okay, so it has a direction. This magnetic field, one shown with the help of a cross and other I am showing with the help of a dot. Now, cross means what? Cross means what? This third dimension, this magnetic field is inward. It is going inside the screen. It is going inwards. And this magnetic field, which is shown with the help of dots, that is coming towards you. That is coming towards you. This field is coming towards you. Okay, this is coming out, outward. And now direction of alpha and beta particle can be given by Fleming's left hand rule. Again, a very important board question. Ki how is the direction of alpha particle and beta particle determined in a magnetic field? So it is determined in a magnetic field by Fleming's left hand rule. So what you can do is you can hold your left hand like this. This is my y axis, this is my x axis, and this is my z axis. Okay, now in this case, z axis is pointing towards you. I can hold it in this way also. So this is x axis, this is y axis, and in this case, this z axis is pointing inwards inside the screen. X axis, y axis, and my middle finger z axis is pointing towards you, and in this case, x axis and y axis here are my magnetic field is going inwards. Have you understood this? So this magnetic field, which is shown with the help of cross, is going inside, and in case of dots, this magnetic field is coming towards you. This magnetic field is coming towards you. We are not worried about the gamma radiations. Gamma radiations go straight without any deviation. And what are we going to do? We are going to show three radiations. So all three gamma radiations going straight without any radiation. Where will alpha particle go? This question was already asked in the examination. So I am not talking anything out of the syllabus. So take your left hand, thumb will show the direction of alpha particle. What you can do is you can write alpha over here. You can look here, on thumb I have written alpha particle. On my index finger I have written M, M for magnetic field. And on my middle finger I have put an arrow. Arrow means direction of the radiation. This is direction of magnetic field and this is the direction of the alpha particle. So see this. My magnetic field is inside and radiations are directed upwards. My thumb will show the direction of alpha particle. I have written alpha on my thumb. Okay. So magnetic field going inside, radiation ka direction is upward. So alpha particle will bend towards which side? It will bend towards the left hand side. So my alpha particles are here bending towards the left side. 1, 2, and 3 alpha particles. And what is the direction of a beta particle? Beta particle will exactly at the direction opposite to direction of the alpha particle. So these beta particles are turning towards this side. So gamma radiation going straight without any deviation, alpha particle according to Fleming's left hand rule turning towards this side, and beta particle, since it has opposite charge, it will turn in the direction opposite to the direction of the beta particle. So don't worry about a beta particle. In whatever alpha particle is going, beta particle will go in the opposite direction. So what here? I am not at all worried about the gamma particle. They will pass straight. So gamma particles pass straight. Now my same left hand, but now my magnetic field is not moving inwards. Instead, it is moving outwards. So in this case, I am going to hold my left hand like this. And what I see is, this is the direction of the radiation. Magnetic field is outwards towards you. And my alpha particle will turn this side. So alpha particles are turning here in the magnetic field, alpha. And what about beta particles? They turn in the direction opposite to the direction of the alpha particles. I hope you have understood this. It is very difficult to teach online all these things. It is better taught in the class, but I have tried my level best and I hope you have understood this. So your thumb will show the direction of the alpha particle. index finger will show the direction of the magnetic field, okay, and your middle finger will show the direction of the radiation. So there are two conditions in a case of magnetic field. What is the direction of a magnetic field? Magnetic field is inward or it is outwards. You can remember in this way also. In case if your magnetic field is directed inwards or shown with the help of a cross, so alpha particle will bend towards the left side, and when it is outward represented by a dot, so your alpha particle will turn towards the right side. But still I will strongly recommend use first three fingers of your left hand. Use Fleming's left hand rule and find out your answer, because question can be tricky. And as far as electric field was concerned, no problem at all. Look at this sign, plus or minus. According to that, decide whether it is going to turn towards left side or a right side. They can trick you with this sign. In your examination, position of plus and minus can be in exactly opposite direction. Alpha particle is a helium nucleus. It has two positive charges. Since it has positive charges, it will bend towards the negative side. And beta particle has a negative charge, so it will turn towards the positive charge. Unlike charges attract one another. So these are the diagrams. Please practice them and understand properly. And in your examination, don't fail to label your diagram, especially alpha, beta and gamma particle. I hope you have understood all the concepts from this video lecture. I always love teaching all the difficult concepts. Few concepts of this chapter are remaining. I'll try to cover them in the next part. So see you all in next part. Till then, bye.